मींस दिस होवर सेलेक्ट जनरली दिस होवर सेलेक्टर इज फॉर सेलेक्टिंग द एलिमेंट्स ओके व्हेन वी मूव द माउस ऑन देम इट इज व्हेन वी माउस ऑन देम इट जनरली चेंजेस टू अनदर कलर ओके See in many websites in some websites you can clearly see that when you click on generally that I mean the default link is in one color when you click on that particular link then it changes to another color okay it is actually happened by using this hover effect only okay and and it is not only limited to the links we can use this hover effect on almost every html element I mean html tags Like you can use this hover effect on a paragraph tag. You can use this hover effect on what is this heading tag. Everything, okay. To style this link to unvisited pages, we can use this link selector. And to style the link for visited pages, we can use this visited selector. See, if you see some geek for geeks or any websites. If you visit that website, then it turns to another color. Generally, defaultly, all links. Let me show you. Actually, Python problems. See, basically, generally, all these links are in green color. When you click on that particular I go back to the yeah see it turns to red color okay actually these things can happen by using this hover effect only I have said now like we can use this link selector like to style the link for visited pages we can use this visitor selector and to style the active links then we can use this active selector this is what this hover effect means okay let me explain some features of which are involved in this effect that is the first feature it changes the color of this background font I have already explained that if you click on that particular link or if you click on that particular content if you click on that particular paragraph or heading tag then it will changes it will change the background color okay and and another thing another feature is it modifies the opacity of the image okay and we can use this property for swapping of images like if you print if you give any images on your website by clicking on that image then it will suddenly changes to another image see in many websites you can clearly see that if you click on that particular image then it will turns to another image actually these things can happen by using this hover effect only okay you can use this hover effect by based upon your need and based upon your urgency let me show one example here example I'm using that here I just want to change the paragraph color by using the hover effect oh let me show you here I gave something that is okay vanessa let me print it on blue color Actually, this one is printed in a blue color. Okay. Here, what I want is, if at all, if I click on this particular one is the if at all, if at all, I here, I just want to change the color of this content. I mean, change the color of this paragraph. Okay. Let me show you how we can change the color. Let me change it to red color.
Red color.
This beauty of this hover effect. Default is one is in blue color. When I click on this one is then it turns to red color. Actually, these things can happen by using this hover effect only. You can use this hover effect on images also. Like you can print one image. If you hover on this image, it will turn to another image. Okay, you just do practice on images. This is the example of changing the paragraph color on hover by using this CSS. And you can use this hover effect by the links also. Let me show. Here, let me give one link. Yeah, let me give like for links you have to use this a tag. Let me give class that is link href equals to, and you should close your. Okay. Here what git, and after that you should close your, let me give color that is green. See here I got generally I got this link in a green color. Let me hover on this. When I click on this particular link, then it will turns to another color. Okay, generally defaultly this geek link in green color. When I hover on this geek link, it will turns to blue color. This is how you can apply the hover effect to this particular link. Like you can change the link colors on hover by using this CSS. This is how you can use this hover effect on links. Okay, you can instead of here. Here I gave paragraph. Instead of paragraph, you can use even heading tags or anything. Like let me delete this paragraph. Here I just. You don't need to do anything. You have to change the tags. That's it. See, everything works perfectly. This is how you can use this hover effect on to change the paragraph colors, heading colors, and links. Okay, and you can even use this hover effect on images also. Okay, this is all about the hover effect. What is this hover effect means? This hover effect generally used for you. This selector is for selecting the elements when we move to mouse on them. Okay. This is all about the hover effect, and now I want to explain you guys about another property, that is CSS important property. This property in CSS is used to give more importance compared to this normal property. Okay, like this important means if you use this particular important tag, important property, then you can conclude that that particular content is, this is very important. Okay, and I have already explained that you have to use this rule. When you think that that particular content is most important, then only you have to use this CSS important property. Okay, I already gave somewhat theoretical explanation about this CSS important property. Let me do coding. See, here I gave something. Here I gave color blue. How we can use this important property means you don't need to do anything. You have to use this symbol. Followed by you had to print important. That's it. See, it doesn't change anything. Okay, this is what the important property means. It doesn't hover because I have said that this particular content, this particular paragraph, paragraph that is one is a should be in blue color only. Okay, means so that's where you can use this important property. Means when you think that that particular content that when you think that that particular content on that particular website is most important, then you can use this important property. You can even using this property on any, I mean, any tags. Okay, you can use this particular content on I mean, heading tags, paragraph tags. That's all about your wish. Or you can even use that if you want to put some border color, some border to fix that, like that particular border color is most important, then you can use this important property in such cases. Okay, this is how we can use this important property. This property in CSS is used to give more importance to give more importance compared to this normal property. This is all about the CSS important property. And now I'm going to explain you guys about background size property. I think so I have gave theoretical explanation about this background size property. Let me give some slight introduction about this background size property. This background size CSS property is used to set the size of the background image of an element. Okay, the generally images are in not all images are in not size. Okay, some images are in big size, but our website is very small. Then in such cases, you have to minimize, like you have to short your images. Okay, the in such cases, this background size property is mostly used. This background image can be stretched or are decreased to fit into the existing space. Okay, it allows us to control the scaling of the background image. And coming to the properties, like these properties can be defined by using this length, or you can use length, or you can use percentage, or you can use numbers like keyword values. Okay, it's all about your wish. And generally, it has two possible keyword values that can contain that are generally contain and cover, and it it's a single value syntax defines the width of the image, like in case the height sets to auto, and whereas the double values defines the value of this both height and width. Okay, in which the first value sets the width, and here the second value sets the width. If you give only single value, then it controls that that particular value defines for the width, and the rest value turns to, I mean, then the height value becomes auto. Like if you give two values, then the first value will be height and the second value will be width. Sorry, the first value will be width and the second value will be height. Okay. And another thing is, if an element has multiple background images, then we can define the comma separated values to define the background size of each one. And coming to the properties, property values of this background size, the first one here is auto. Actually, this is the default value which displays the background image in its original size. Okay, here you don't need to decrease. I mean, here this property doesn't decrease or doesn't increase your image. It will display your background image as its original size. Okay, and the second property, that is length. Okay, what is this length means? It is used to set the width and height of this background image. Okay, and this value stretches the image in the corresponding dimensions of this given length. I have said that if the single value is given, then it specifies that it is generally defined for width of the image. And the height sets to auto. Like if you given two values, then the first value sets to width, and here the second value sets to the height. Okay. And the another thing is, and the another thing that you should keep in your mind, that it doesn't allow negative values. You should You should give all the length values in a positive values, okay? You are not supposed to give negative values. This is all about the length property. And followed by, we have another property, that is the percentage property. What is this percentage property means? This percentage property generally defines the width and height of this background images in a percentage, okay? You have to give the values in a percentage, like 10%, 30%, 50%, 100%. You should give your values in a percentage. And here also negative values are not allowed. You should give all positive percentages only. And another property, that is cover. What does this cover mean? This value is used to resize the background image to cover the entire container, okay? And sometimes it drops the little bit of one of the edges or stretches the image. And it resizes the image to ensure that the element is completely covered. And we have another property, that is content. What is this content? Content means without stretching or cropping, okay? It resizes the background image to ensure the image is completely visible. This is the beauty of this content property. And coming to the initial property, it sets the property to its default value. And we have another property, that is inherit. The name itself says that this inherit property, I mean this inherit property generally inherits all the properties from its parent element. Name itself says. Let me explain. Here, let me give an image. Oh. I got some, yeah. This is the original image. Now here I just want to decrease the width and height. Okay, let me show how we can. Set width, that is, sorry, width 100 pixel, and height also. See, it minimizes the image. Generally, this particular image is, I mean, the here the width is 100 pixel and the height is 100 pixel. This is how we can use these background size property. See, when you create some websites, we don't have only images. Like we have some paragraphs, we have some boxes, we have some sections, okay? In such cases, you have to adjust your images, okay? So in that particular situations, these background size properties are used, okay? See, here I have minimized the images. For this particular website, I have much space. Means here I can add many more elements, or here I can add many much content. Okay. This is how you can use this background size property. And you can even, I have already explained that you can use, let me show you. Let me delete all this. Here you should give the background size property. Background size. Let me give the, what is this first one? Background size, let me think auto. this is the default one, and this is how I have already explained that auto means it prints its original size. Okay, and we have another background size property, that is pixel. Let me set 150 pixel, 300 pixel. Here the first one defines the width, and here the second value defines the height. I have already explained that if you give two values, here the first one defines, here the first one sets to width, and here the second one sets to height. If at all if you give only one value, then here the first one value, here the one, I mean the single value will sets to width, and the height sets to zero. I mean, sorry, auto. Is not changing. Okay. Sorry, you should when you use this background image, then you should give the URL. Let me delete this. Let me give some div tag. Let me give here id equals to a, and you should close your div tag. Here I gave id, that is a, right? Let that in the form. One second, guys. me give in percentage. Let me give background size that is cover. Let me give initial. Nothing is working. Why? Instead of image. Oh, sorry, I didn't see your messages. Will its font size increase automatically or we have to give? Sorry, I didn't get you. Will its font size increases automatically or we have to give? We have to give the font sizes, okay? Like if you zoom your website, then only the font size increase. Instead of image. For which one? Soundarya? For hover na? Last program. Background. Here I am explaining background size property. Before that I have explained important property. And before that I have explained hover property. That's it. Right now I am explaining background size property. Background video is possible. I think so. Yeah, it is possible. See, in many websites, some videos are in very short size. Background size is generally applicable to every tag. Okay. Guys, I don't know why this background size, like, what is this? Why it is not applying to anything? Let me add at least class. And right now I'm going to explain you guys about CSS line height property. This CSS line height property is used to define the minimal height of line boxes within the element. Like it sets the difference between these lines of your content. Let me share my screen. This line height generally defines the amount of this space above and below the inline elements. Okay, like if you want to give some see in some websites you can see that there is a space. Okay, there is a space, like there is a line height between one content and the another content. Actually those things can happen by using this line height property only. Like if at all if you want to give some space above or below the inline elements, then You can use this line height property. It allows you to set the height of a line or line of independently from the font size. Okay. And coming to the properties, here we have many line height properties. That is, one is normal. Actually, this is the default value. It specifies a normal line height. And followed by, we have another property that is number property. It specifies a number that is multiplied with the current font size to set the line height. Okay. And followed by, and we have here the length property also. It means we can set, you can set the line height by using some pixels, pt, centimeters, geoish. And here we have another beautiful property that is percentages. It specifies the line height in the percent, like you can give 1%, 2%, 5%, 10%, so much. And I have said that we have inherit and initial. Initial means it sets, this property sets this default value. And coming to the inherit, this inherit means this property, it inherits this property from its parent element, okay? Let me give an example. Let me create some lines. Let me create one paragraph. And after that, here you should give some ID or class. Class here, that is A. Let me give another paragraph. Here, class B. Python. Class C, let me give hello. Okay, yeah, successfully I have wrote all the HTML tags. Let me add CSS. First one, what? Sorry, P. P.PA. B. Let me give height in percentages. And followed by, we have another paragraph, that is C. Sorry. Line height. Oh, 90%. Actually, instead of refreshing my HTML page, here every time I'm refreshing my Google page. Let me change line height instead of 90, let me give what, 500. See, you can clearly see that the difference between one paragraph, you can clearly see that the line height difference between one paragraph tag and another paragraph tag, like compared to the this one and this one, this one is somewhat bigger, because here I gave the values, like here I gave the line height 70%, but coming to this another paragraph tag, here I gave the line height, that is 500%. Okay, this is how you can use this line height property. Generally, this is how line height property works. See, in many websites, you can see that there is a line height, difference between one paragraph or one particular content and another particular content or one section. Like there is a difference, there is a height difference between one section and the another section. Actually, those things can happen by using this line height property only. And you can use this break also, but instead of break, this works this looks effective, okay? You can even use the break tags also. Okay. This is what this CSS line height property means. Okay. If at all, if you want to set any line height between your paragraph tags or heading tags or anything or any sections, or even you can use this line height property on images. On images also, then you can use this line height property. And followed by, we have another property, that is the CSS margin property. This CSS margin property is used to define the space around the elements. Okay, it is completely transparent and doesn't have any background color. Okay, and it clears an area around an element. Okay. Means top, bottom, left, right margins can be changed independently using separate properties. Like we have margin left, margin right, margin bottom, margin top. You can also change all properties at once by using this shortened margin property. I will explain. If at all, if you give margin like this, if at all, if you give this shortened margin property, then this property is used to set the all properties in one declaration. Like it sets margin left, margin right, margin top, and margin bottom. Four corners, okay? We have another property, that is margin left. What is this margin left means? It is used to set the left margin of an element. And coming to the margin right, it is used to set the right margin of an element. Margin top means it is used to set the top margin of an element. Coming to the bottom margin, it is used to set the bottom margin of an element. Okay. Like coming to the values, like background size, everything, we have the same values like auto, length, percentages, inherit. You can use anything based upon your need and it's your wish. Let me give one example. Here. Okay. Here, let me. I wrote some content. Here, for this particular paragraph, here I just want to add all the margins like margin top, margin bottom, margin right, and margin left. Let me add. Let me delete this line height property. Here, you have to give margin top. Let me give some 50 pixels. And followed by, we have margin bottom. Let me give this also 50 pixels. Margin left, 100 pixels. And margin right, that is also 100 pixels. See? Let me minimize this content. See, you got everything perfectly. Here I gave margin left, margin top, that is 50 pixel, margin bottom 50 pixel. So that's why there is a difference between this one and this one. And they have given that margin right, that is 100 pixel. See, compared to this margin top and margin right is somewhat bigger, because here I gave this margin top, that is 50 pixel only. Here the margin left is double, means 100 pixel. That's why, compared to this height and this width, there is a difference between both the cases, like both the margin top and the margin right, because the length values are different. Okay, this is how you can use this margin values. I think so. If you see any document type of, if you see any website, there is some content is printed in such way, like there is a space from left side, and there is somewhat space from the right side. actually you can give spaces by using this margin property only, like you by using this margin right property and margin left property. Let me delete all this. Instead of giving all these properties, you can use this one shortened margin property. Like you don't need to do anything here. Let me give margin. That is 50 pixels. See, hello is compared to this previous one. Hello position is changed because here the margin top 50, margin left 50, margin right 50, margin bottom 50. This is how you can use this margin property. Okay. And we have some types, like you can, here I gave only one value, that is 50 pixel. Let me give all let me give four values. Let me give 50 pixel, 100 pixel, 150 pixel, 200 pixel. Generally here the 50 pixel means this is margin top. Okay, here the 100 pixel means this is margin right, and here the 150 means here it stands for margin bottom, and coming to the last one, this stands for the margin left. Okay, let me show you. See, here the hello is printed. Okay, compared to the previous one, the position of this hello is changed. Here I gave values, that is 50, 100, 150, 200. The first one here, the 50 stands for the margin top. Okay, and the here 100 pixel means it sets for margin right. Okay, and the next one is margin. I mean here the 150 pixel stands for the margin bottom, and here the left means here 200 it stands for margin left. Okay, this is 200 pixel. Like if you give four values, then it will set in such a way, like first one top, right, bottom and left. What if I gave only three values? Okay, let me give only three values. Let me delete this 200 pixel. Okay. Once again.
Hey Manju, what is your conclusion?
Okay. Here I gave only three values. These three values generally, here the first value sets for top, I mean margin top. Okay, here the 50 pixel stands for margin top. And here, once again. Here I gave only three values. Here the first value generally stands for margin top, and here the second value stands for the here the 100 pixel generally stands for both left and right. Okay, here the 150 pixel means what? Bottom, margin bottom. Okay, compared to the previous one, the position of this hello is slightly changed. Here the top sets for 50 pixel, left and both left and right is 100 pixel, and here the bottom is 150 pixel. Okay, this is how, if you give three values in this way, this margin property works. What if I gave only two values? Let me delete this 150 pixel. See, if you give only two values, here the first value stands for top and bottom. Okay, 50 pixel means top and bottom, and the second value is sets for both left and right. Okay, what if you get two values? This 50 pixel sets for all these four values, like top, right, bottom and left. Okay, this is how margin property works. Okay, you can give any value. You can give margin properties in this way, or you can use or you can pray, you can like you can write this margin property in this way, like instead of writing all four values, you can set here like what is this 50 pixel, 50 pixel, 100 pixel, 100 pixel. This case, I mean here, this p dot a and p dot c, both cases are same, okay. And another thing is, you can even give three values, you can give two values, you can give like shortened property, that is one value. It's all about your wish, okay. I hope everything is clear till now. This is how generally margin property works. We have four, I mean, we can use this margin property in this way, or you can use this margin property in the shortened way, like you can give four values, three values, two values, one value. This is all about the CSS margin property, okay. And followed by, we have another property, that is CSS opacity property. What is the CSS opacity property means? This CSS opacity properties is generally used to specify the transparency of an element, okay. In simple word, you can say that it specifies the clarity of an image, okay. Coming to the in technical terms, we can say that opacity is defined as the degree in which the light is allowed to travel through an object, okay. See, generally with websites, some websites are in some websites are in bright color and some websites are in dull color, okay. Actually, these things can happen by using this opacity only. Like if you give higher opacity value, then your image is brighter. If you give low opacity values, then your image becomes too dull. Okay. This opacity property is used to specify the transparency of an element. Okay. And how we can apply this opacity setting means, opacity setting is applied uniformly, okay, across the entire object, and the opacity value is defined in terms of a digital value that is less than one only, okay. You have to give this opacity values less than one. The lesser opacity values displays this greater opacity, okay. And there is another thing that you should keep in your mind, that is opacity is not inherited, okay. Let me print one transparent image. Image class, that is D. You should close your image time. Image short, I class for D, right? Sorry. And let me give here opacity, that is. Let me print the default value, so you can clearly see that there is difference between this opacity and the normal value. Image. See, you can clearly see that the difference between the original image and the opacity applied image, okay. This is how generally opacity works. I have already said that this property is generally used to specify the transparency of an image, okay. See, here you can clearly see that the difference between normal image and the transparent image. Actually, this is the original image and this is the transparent image. See, in some websites you can see that generally some images are in normal way and some images are in a transparent way, okay. You may think that how these images are printed, okay. See, you can declare that this is how that those transparent images are printed. Okay, you don't need to do anything. You have to use this only. You have to use this opacity property. Okay, if you use this opacity properties, then you can print your images in a transparent way. This is all about this transparent property. Opacity property. I have said that opacity property is used to specify the transparent of an image. Here instead of 5, let me give 0.1. See, the transparency is very less than. I have said that if you give the more, the greater this, the lesser the opacity value displays this greater opacity. Okay, here I gave this very less opacity so that it displays this greater opacity image. This is all about this opacity property. And followed by, we have another property, that is the filters. Okay, see, in social media, or like if you take WhatsApp, Instagram, we have many filters. If you open your WhatsApp, like there are some filters like brightness, some dull, some gray color images, very dull, transparent, saturate. Actually, those all these things can happen by using this filter property. Like we have many in CSS, we have many filter properties, that is brightness, saturate, blur, and hue, rotate, opacity, grayscale. I will explain all of them. Let me give somewhat explanation about this. Filter property. Actually, CSS filters are used to set the visual effects to text, or you can text, images, or any other aspects of the your websites, or you can apply it to tables, lists. It's all about your wish. But mostly, I recommend you guys to use this filter properties on images. Okay, you can clearly see the difference. Okay. This CSS filter property allows us to access the effects such as color or brightness, blur, or shifting on the rendering of an element before the element gets displayed. Okay. Let me show some of these properties. Here, coming to the first property, that is the brightness property. What is this brightness means? As its name implies, it is used to set the brightness of an image. Brightness, so not only image, you can set it to a paragraph, other tags, like other, you can apply this brightness to text also. But here I'm taking an example, that is image. If this brightness is 0%, then it represents completely black. Okay, let me show. Where is this opacity? Let me delete this opacity. Let me add this filter. What is filter? First property, brightness, right? One second. Brightness 0%. Wow. One second. One second, guys. Okay. See, you can. Clearly see the difference between this. Don't see the difference. Here I gave that brightness is 0%. Means if you gave this brightness 0%, then it will completely turns to black. Okay, see, this image completely turns to black. Let me change this brightness to some 90%. think so. We won't see this. Let me give 150%. Okay. See, this is the original image, and this is the image that I have applied some filters like brightness 150. You can clearly see the difference between this original image and this image. Okay. See here, the brightness is 150. So that's why means we can see. We generally, visually, we can see the difference. Okay. How we can apply this brightness property? Okay, if you give here, let me give 100%. See, both are same. Means here the 100% represents the original one. Okay, original image. And you can give above 100, like what? You can give 200, 300. It's your wish. But if you give 100%, then it will print your original image. This is what this brightness property means. And we have another filter, that is blur filter. It is used to apply the blur effect to that element. Let me show. Let me delete this brightness to blur. Let me change this brightness to blur. The image is like not only see the image is slightly blurred compared to this original one. If you give 10 pixel, then it completely blurred. Or you can give above 10 pixel, like you can give 50 pixel, 30 pixel. It's your wish. Okay, see the image is blurred. Okay, this is how you can use this blur property. Everything works perfectly. See, this is the beauty of the CSS. Okay, means we can print our, we can make everything in our wish. Means we can change our images to brightness, or we can change our images to blur. We have some other filters also, like invert, saturate. I will explain them. This is how this blur property works. And we have followed by, we have another filter, that is the invert filter. What is this invert filter mean? It is used to invert the samples in the input image. Okay, means here it's the 100% value represents completely inverted, and here this 0%, like 0% values leaves the underchanged input. And there is another thing that you should keep in your mind, that here the negative values are not allowed. Okay, you are not supposed to use any negative values. You have to use all these positive values only. Let me change blur to invert property. Invert, let me give 50. See, this is how image, like here I'm looking like a devil. Okay, means this is how we can use this invert property. I have already explained that if you give 100%, let me give 100. This is completely inverted. If you give 0%, it hasn't changed. Okay, this is the difference between the 0 and the 100. Okay, you can give in between values like 30 40 60. Okay, this is how invert filter works. Okay, and we have another filter, that is the saturate filter. What is the saturate filter means? It sets the saturation of an element. Okay, and here the 0%, here the zero saturation represents the completely, completely unsaturated element. Let me give here 0. See, there is no difference between both are same images. Like there is no difference between both images. Means if you give 0% saturation, means it will print the original one, means it's completely unsaturated element. Okay, whereas here let me give 100%. It's completely saturated. Kapu, I mean, I think so. Oh, sorry, I didn't change the invert to saturate. Sorry, saturate. Okay, this is how saturation works. Like, see, if you work with OpenCV projects or anything, then you there is an object detail, like somewhat what is this pen detect object detection mode, pen detection. Like if you work on OpenCV, then in such cases saturation, we use the saturation many times. Like what is this? If you work on OpenCV, then only you can understand how the saturation works. Like there are many filters on this saturations. So I have deleted that particular saturation matrix. Okay, whatever. This is how generally saturation works. You can even give, let me give 50. Compared to the previous one, it slightly changed. Okay, if you give 0, okay, then it is an unsaturated element. It looks like it is some gray color image. Okay, this is how saturation generally works. You can even give 40, 50, 60, anything. That's all about your wish. And followed by, we have another property, that is the drop shadow. What is this drop shadow means? It applies the drop shadow effect to this input image. Okay, let me show you. So, let me delete this saturate property. Here, I just want to drop. Where is this drop shadow? Yeah, drop shadow. Here you have to give 4 values. Here the first one for H shadow and the second one for B shadows. Fourth one here the first one, let me give actually. Here the first one 10 pixel. Don't need to mention any comma. 20 pixel. 30 pixel. Here I just want to get the shadow in a green color. Okay, here I, so that's why here again giving color that is green. See, you got actually let me delete this image. You can clearly see that there is a box shadow that actually the color here, I gave the color here I gave the color green, so that's why here we got some box shadow which is in green color. Okay, this is how box shadow filter works. And followed by, we have another filter, that is the contrast. What is this contrast means? It adjusts the contrast of this inputs. Okay, if at all if you give this 0% value, then it will create a completely black image. Let me show you. Let me delete this drop shadow. Here I just want to give, what is this contrast? Contrast here, first of all, let me give 0%. See, it completely turns to black. Okay, means let me give here 100%. Here compared to the previous, compared to the previous one, it changes. Means if you give 0%, means it will create, it will changes, it will turns to completely black image. Whereas if you give 100%, it will it will leave that unchanged. Like there is no difference between this particular image and this particular image. Okay, and here let me give what 200. See, you can clearly see the difference between this original image and the contrast image. Means here values that which are greater than, okay, values greater than 100% are allowed. Okay, values greater than 100% are only allowed. Okay, you are not supposed to give the values which are below the 100%, okay? And if you give this, I have already explained that if you give 0% value, then it will turns to completely black. If you give 100%, then it will turns to unchanged, like mute. I mean, there is no change. There is no change. I mean, there is no difference between this original image and the contrast image. You have to mention above the 100%. Like you can give this 200%, 300%, 500%. It's your wish, okay? This is how this contrast filter works. This is all about these filters. Like we have one another filter that is hue rotate. Like it there's the hue rotation on this input image. Like its perimeter value defines this number of degrees around the color circle, and this image will be adjusted. And here the default value is the degree value, which represents the original image. And here the maximum is 360 degrees. Whatever, let me print. There is a lot of symbols to discuss. Hue rotate. Let me give 200 degrees. Okay. This is how hue rotate works. Hit the large value, I mean the highest value here is 360 only. Okay. This is how hue rotate works. And we have another filter, that is the grayscale. What is this grayscale? Means it converts this image into black, okay? In our WhatsApp, WhatsApp filters, we have this grayscale filter. Like it generally turns our images into grayscale image. Here the 0% grayscale image represents the original one, whereas the 100% represents the completely grayscale. And let me show you. Let me give grayscale, that is 80% or 90%. See, this is how grayscale image looks like. Like if you give 0%, then it remains unchanged. Okay, both are same. This is what this grayscale means. We have another property, that is sepia. Like it is also used to transform your image into sepia. Like here the 0% value represents the original value, whereas the 100% value indicates the complete. This is all about the CSS filters, okay? You can use any filter based upon your need, okay? You please do practice once so that you can see the beauty in the CSS, okay? You can, by doing practice only, you can understand the depth in every concept, okay? Then only you can understand how these filters are generally works, how we can change our images to another format, another filter. Like you can change your image into some like grayscale image, some saturate image, you can even apply opacity, or you can change your images to some brightness, you can change your images to blur, everything, okay? Please do practice on filters. And followed by, we have another CSS. Here I just want to explain another concept, that is CSS images. Sanjeev sir, okay guys, it's high time. People are guys, you can leave now. Thanks to one and all. Yeah, thank you.